Let's start with a quick tour to learn the major components. Now, Civil 3D is built on AutoCAD, so it has many of the same basic components of AutoCAD, and then some. For example, it has this Start tab where you can open, create new drawings, access recent drawings, even access your BIM 360 account, and many other things. I'll go ahead and open a drawing. And now that we're in the drawing, we'll be able to talk about some of the other user interface components. Here at the top left corner, you see the big blue C for Civil 3D, and if I click that, it expands what's called the application menu. This area here is called the drawing area, and in this particular drawing, I have three viewports, but all three of them together represent the drawing area. Down here at the bottom, I've got the command line, and the command line is kind of a chat window that you use to communicate back and forth with Civil 3D. At the top of the screen, I have the ribbon, and the ribbon is where I'm going to launch most of the commands that I use in Civil 3D. On the left side of the screen, I see the tool space, and you can see that the tool space is made up of multiple tabs: Prospector, Settings, Survey, and Toolbox. Those are the main components of the Civil 3D user interface, but to finish the full list of components, I'm going to call up a few kind of random tools. The first one is the Inquiry tool. I'll go to the Analyze tab of the ribbon and launch Inquiry tool over here on the right. And the reason I brought this up is it's kind of its own user interface component. It's unique. With this tool, you can query your drawing for information about points, surfaces, alignments, and so on. Another kind of random user interface component is the panorama. To see the panorama, I'll go to the Home tab, expand here where it says Palettes, and I'll click this icon for the Event Viewer. Now, the panorama can house a lot of different information. In this case, we're calling up the events information, which are things that may happen in your drawing, errors and things like that, that you may need to know about. You can see currently that my event viewer is blank. But really what I'm talking about here is this panorama window. And there's some unique behavior with the panorama window. For example, I can collapse and expand it. I can control things like transparency and whether it's auto-hidden. It's its own kind of palette, and it has some specific uses within Civil 3D. And then finally, we've got transparent commands. These are over on the right of my screen, and these are a few unique toolbars that you'll only find in Civil 3D. In fact, I'm going to click this one and drag it out so that you can see the other toolbar that's kind of hidden beneath it. These are specific drafting commands that make use of some of the functionality in Civil 3D. Before you do anything in Civil 3D, you'll need to open a drawing. And that's done with, in addition to the Start tab, the Application menu. So let's start with the Application menu as our first detailed tour. You'll find the Application menu under the big blue C in the top left corner of your screen. I'll click in that location, and you can see all the commands that are listed there. Let's start by simply opening a drawing. From here, I'll click Open, I'll click Drawing, and I'll click Open. Now let's go back to the application menu and talk about some of the different menus and commands that we see there. We see a new menu where I can start a new drawing or a new sheet set. I can open a number of different kinds of files. You'll notice that drawing is not the only kind. I can save the file that I'm working in, or I can save it as a different file name or file type. I can export what's in my drawing to a bunch of different formats. I can publish what I'm working on to additional formats, even 3D printing, as you see at the top, or e-transmit, where I'm sending the drawing as well as supporting files that may need to go with it. Printing and plotting are stored in the print menu. From here, I can take my drawing and plot it to paper, or even 3D print it. Next, we see drawing utilities, where I can do things like compare two drawings to see where the changes are, audit a drawing to remove any errors that might be inside of it, or even access drawing settings to control some of the behavior of the drawing. And then even close has multiple options. I can close the current drawing, or I can close all the drawings that I currently have open. Which, by the way, it is possible to open multiple drawings in Civil 3D, and each one will become a tab across the top. Now, one of the most powerful and frankly least used components of the application menu is right here at the top, where I can search for commands. You know, when you know that command is in there, but you just can't quite remember what it's called or where it's located in the ribbon, you can just type it in. And the application menu is going to show you all the different matches to the keyword that you've typed in. And I can actually launch the line command right here from this list. In this section, we have the recent documents that we've opened. And this is really powerful because you'll find yourself while you're doing a day's work that you're in and out of the same files pretty frequently. So this is a very efficient way to get to a file that maybe you had open earlier this morning or even yesterday. Now you can control the way this list is sorted by name, by access date, size, or type. You can also control the way it's displayed, small icons the whole way up to large images. And these images can give you a bit of a clue as to what you're trying to open. You can even pin a drawing to the application menu. So if this drawing is something that I know I'm going to be getting into every day for maybe the next few weeks, I can pin it here and it will always appear at the top of the list, even though I may have opened many drawings since the last time I opened it. At the bottom, we see the options command, which is a powerful dialog box where you can access lots and lots of different settings inside of your AutoCAD and Civil 3D environment. And then to the right of that, we can click this button to simply exit Civil 3D. By the way, you should know that if you double click the application menu icon at the top left of the screen, it will exit you out of Civil 3D. Typically, users find that out in a way that they didn't intend to do it. If Civil 3D suddenly shuts down and you're wondering what happened, it may be that you've simply double clicked the blue C. So there you have it. Now you know all about the application menu and what it can do.